Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today's upload is on a very sought after flipper from the model's very first run. And I'm referring to the Synapse flipper knife by Vero Engineering. And this isn't just any Synapse, but it's the big body, the XL model. Vero is responsible for its famous pry bar and drill bit pocket tool, the fulcrum. Anyway, if you've been under a rock somewhere, Vero has taken the industry by storm as of late via Instagram, other social media platforms, and new ways of promoting and marketing. The Synapse XL being one of their recent byproducts, I got a chance to get one up on the channel, so let's jump right in. The Synapse XL comes in with a closed length of 5 inches, and is comprised of high-grade titanium that has been dressed in Vero's raw finish, which is definitely a tumble. The Synapse is running a bolster locking system that gives it that standalone look, and not to say a bolster is anything new, but done in this fashion is. The satin finish disc pivot adds some contrast, but continues with the elegant theme of the knife. With the first run available in either G10 or micarta, this is the micarta inlay that is very high quality and will age with time and absorption of oil. The pocket clip fits the build's aesthetics and functions very well going in and out of the pocket. The design leaves the clip floating via an underlying screw and this one of only 2 visible body screws on the show side. Simple, yet very innovative, and having minimally exposed hardware is sought after. The 3D milled solid titanium backspacer is smooth with no jimping at all, and unlike my favorite type, a geared style spacer that is commonly used on majority of today's designs, this style lends more to a gentleman's or a high-end carry. The build doesn't have a lanyard hole or slot, which I believe an empty hole or a hanging lanyard would take away from the Synapse's extremely clean look. All the hardware on the build accepts T8 hex bits. Upon first glance, the Synapse, especially when viewed from the show side, can seem confusing to some in terms of its means of deployment. Technically speaking, the build has 2 means of deployment, but there is an array of ways these can be utilized. If you look at the bolster spine side edge, you will notice that it has been relieved, exposing the flipper tab, which in my opinion, reacts more like a lever style action. The tab is one of only 2 places on the Synapse that are jimped or textured in any fashion. The jimping covers the entire front side that would be used when light switching the tab and continues just beyond the crown of the tab for those utilizing the push button method. And the second method is a bit of a hidden feature from the show side, but definitely presents the blade with much more authority. And it's a strategically placed fuller. And of course in Vero fashion, it isn't your ordinary everyday fuller, but something you will see on a futuristic steampunk style razor out of Mad Max. And if you note the arch that starts in the bolster's rear and continues for about 40% of the inlay, this is where the fuller rests in the closed position. Easily accessible to be flicked by all 4 fingers, the Synapse was engineered in such a way to not leave us fidgeters out in the cold, yet clean enough to speak to one's contemporary likes on a minimalistic level. The blade spine side is the second and only remaining area where jimping is present, and due to pivot placement, the spine's edge ending above the pivot and grip provided by this jimping, front flipping the Synapse becomes a viable deployment option. The blade comes in at 3 8/500 of an inch in length with a blade thickness of 157/1000 of an inch, and is offered in stone wash, belt satin finish, and my personal favorite, the hand rub satin finish as seen on this Synapse. Sporting a flat ground drop point blade made from M390 steel. And in my opinion, this blade is very beautiful. The hand rub is even with no imperfection, and the blade lines remain distinct and visible, when in most cases a hand rubbed finish can reduce lines and definition, in addition to blurring or even masking fine detail work, which here it didn't do any of that. The blade shape is also very appealing, with the whole front end being tip and belly, then breaking into a flat edge on the remaining blade. The action on this flipper is unique in the fact that I can't really feel the detent. I mean, I know it's there and I hear the break. It's just a smooth push, no initial resistance before the break. The Synapse is also running an internal stop pin, adding more strength and preventing side-to-side blade play. And my favorite feature on the Synapse is the fuller. If you're familiar with the channel, this comes as no surprise. And I'm a fan of its design as well. While the typical fuller has rounded edges that gradually rise back to the blade side, these areas are too smooth and for the most part can't be used to flick, while the rectangle allows more usable real estate. And all the corners and edges have been knocked down. And as I previously stated, this can be accessed and flicked into lockup using any of the four fingers. Running on Skiff bearings that I must say are very stocky in a good way. And they have this blade sliding on rails, so to speak, locked in. And another characteristic I love about the build just as much as the aesthetics is its retraction and how it can be fine-tuned to your preference. I'm sure if you're familiar with this knife, you've seen them tuned to slam shut, like the front door of a forgotten side chick on Valentine's Day. But I prefer more of the valet, soft and subtle, getting back into my car, slow, soft closing. And okay, maybe I'm getting off track, but the point is, we can choose and tune, and you have to admit, that's some good action on a beefy blade. And located at the top of the flipper tab, you will see the number 127, this being from the first run of 250. On the opposite side, the blade spine, you will see Vero. Then on a pocket clip, rest the company's logo. The Synapse has very little branding on the build, which is another awesome aspect. The blade, when viewed from its sides, is completely sterile. No steel stamp or any place of origin. All around, this is an awesome build with innovative engineering, killer aesthetics, and a very high fidget factor. Even the pouch that it comes in is levels above what you usually receive. And not that it's some high-end chinchilla or anything, but I believe it was made in such a way that had us, the consumer, in mind. Like they asked themselves, what would make someone want to carry a knife pouch? And that's what they implicated into this design. And finally, the info card, which comes along in the pouch. And this one, stating the number and which batch, the knife model and finish, inlay materials, in addition to a branded cleaning cloth, and everything you could need. So with that, I'll be returning with a true review after some time with the Synapse XL. If you like the content, hit the thumbs up and sub to the channel. And please comment with your thoughts on the Synapse XL by Vero Engineering. With that, I'm signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.